Okay, what I got here is the new engine upside down because I have to change the dipstick. Now the dipstick needs to come out of here, which has a plug in it, and be removed from the opposite side, because when the exhaust manifold goes on here, the dipstick that came with the vehicle, the old engine, curves around and comes outside of the manifold. But the dipstick they gave me on this engine will go right through the manifold, so that's unacceptable. Here is our dipstick tube. We need it to go here. There's a screw right here that come off the other engine that'll install it right there. So here goes nothing, it hurt. It's moving. Nothing to it. There it is. Just a small pluck. And there's no sealer on that at all. It's just driven in because there's no pressure here really. Alright, this is the old Pitney Bowes brass punch. It's supposed to be softer than steel, so wood is not gonna work. And it is working. She's coming out. Coming out in two pieces. That's really strange. That's not what I expected. All right, I'm ready to put the oil pan back on now. There was a little bit of gasket debris in the oil pan. I cleaned that up. I cleaned this up. This here, the gasket has come loose. So being that I've got a little bit of this RTV red high temp, I'm gonna put a little dab of this here. Thank you. The end result of all this is that we now have the dipstick tube here on the opposite side of where it was, and I'm utilizing the old dipstick tube from the other engine. This is a new exhaust manifold. Dipstick tube comes around the manifold. Now on the other side, where the original dipstick was right there, and when I'm sure that everything's all set, I'm going to drive a plug in there. Because right here on this side, on the exhaust manifold, there's a descending tube, I guess it's called the collector, out the exhaust. So it will be right where this is, so that would not work for this configuration. Well, it's back up on the wooden crate on the hydraulic lift so I can get up and work on it. It's in a safe position. Not going to take this crane down quite yet, but I don't really anticipate on using it. Just the engine hoist to get the motor in when the time comes. So that's where we're at.